2024 is the year of Sophie and Slash. And it goes so well.
Exactly, exactly. Avengers Assemble, let's do it.
Yes.
Sophie Lloyd, good afternoon. How are you?
Hello, I'm good, thank you. I was saying I'm very cold. It was the storm last night, so we're still braving the fact that our chair has been knocked over in the garden.
It's a shame for your chair. Hopefully you have other chairs.
We have one, but you know, it was the favourite, really. So
it was the favourite. Oh,
it's quite
no.
Heartbreaking.
Well, apart from the weather, how's 2024 going so far?
Really good. It's very busy. We got so much going on. Just in a couple of days, we're off to LA. We're going to NAMM for the first time. I've never been to NAMM before. And we're doing some shows with MGK. I've got NASCAR out there, which will be really fun. So yeah, it's already shaping up to be a very busy year.
Already all kicking off. I mean, how'd you top last year? I mean, 2023 was pretty phenomenal, wasn't it?
Oh, it was. It was like, honestly, one of like the best years of my life. Like it was incredible. Like we did a Europe tour. We released the album finally after like 4 years or something that we've been working on it. So yeah, I'm excited for more this year.
Yeah, I mean, you talk about your debut album there, Imposter Syndrome. It's what a moment for you, an interesting title as well. I think we can all relate to that. Do you often feel like an imposter?
Definitely. I think because I kind of had an unconventional start to music where I came from a small town, so there wasn't really many like jam nights or live gigs that I could like go to and learn that way. So it's always kind of been over the internet. Like I uploaded my first YouTube video to like sort of meet other musicians. And I think having that barrier there of like being behind a screen, I really developed this kind of performance anxiety, imposter syndrome that this album has really kind of helped me overcome and heal through.
But now you've got, I mean, a million followers on Insta, a million on YouTube, your tour with MGK, released your debut record of all these great collaborators. Surely no longer, you can't feel like an imposter now. You're doing it.
No, I think it's definitely been incredible, like the past couple of years, just to really kind of break out of it. And I do think I have definitely healed from it. There's still like elements of it. Like I'm yet to kind of play my debut album live. I think we're going to do some dates later on in the year. So that'll be something different where I'm like the sort of the front woman of the show, if you know what I mean. And I have to do the talking and and all that stuff. So we'll see how that goes.
Yeah, because I suppose at the moment you're part of a larger entity, aren't you? And it's not always your name above the door. So when it is, that's a different thing.
Exactly. That's kind of when the pressure gets on more, because it's your stuff. It's sort of your heart, your stuff that you've put out there. So it's a very different feeling, I think.
So how did it start for you? For people that don't know, I think you alluded to it there. It sort of started for you on YouTube, really. What made you want to put your first video up?
So yeah, it was kind of, I just wanted to meet other musicians because no one in my town really knew what rock music was or anything. I remember I wore a studded bracelet to school once and I got suspended. So it was like, there wasn't really any sort of music scene there. So I put my first video up just to kind of, because YouTube wasn't really a thing. This was maybe 10 years ago or something. I put my first video up as kind of like a diary entry to like track my progress, but also to just maybe like meet some other people as kind of like a portfolio I could send to people if I wanted to like join bands or anything. Like I just wanted like a kind of video diary. And then it just kind of started doing really well out of nowhere. And now here we are.
So did it catch you by surprise a little bit?
Yeah, definitely. I remember when I uploaded my first video, I was like, if I get 30 views, I'll be so happy. And then like overnight it had like 1,000 or something. And I was like, I don't know, those numbers just seem like incomprehensible for me. Like it definitely did, but it's also been a lot of hard work to kind of maintain it and really build it, especially in this climate where it's like quite like oversaturated and stuff.
Yeah, that must be difficult. You know, I hadn't really thought of it like that, but when there are so many people out there, you know, content creators on YouTube, for you to stand out, you have to do something, I suppose, a little bit different. And I mean, was it a case of just trying to come up with creative ideas as to how you can sort of market yourself, what tunes you'd pick to cover, or, you know, things like that?
Yeah, pretty much. Like you sort of have to come up with a brand and then kind of find your like unique selling point, if you know what I mean. So like I do a lot of these like shred versions online of popular songs where I can't sing at all. I'm an awful singer. So I basically play the melody on guitar because I love music with vocals. I just can't sing it, but I want to play it. So and then I kind of just add my little techniques and stuff into it. And that's kind of what I've built Manal off is that. And then I started writing my own original music as well, which people liked. So yeah, it's always like finding what your kind of niche is online, is definitely important.
Amazing. I mean, it wasn't so long ago. We were talking, what, 5 or 6 years? You were still a student at college. Did you go to BIM? You did, didn't you?
Yeah, BIM London, BIM
Yeah.
London.
Yeah. I know the guys at BIM Brighton. It's a great institution, but it must be kind of crazy to think that wasn't that long ago. Did people get in touch with you from there?
Yeah, like it's cool because like I'm still like one of my biggest really influences is a tutor I had there called Jim Clark. And I'm still like in contact with him now. Like whenever I have a question, I'll still be like, can you hop on Zoom and teach me how to play this? And it's so nice. Like it was a really great community there. And it was really good to like meet lots of different contacts and actually get my foot into the music scene a little bit.
Amazing. And tell us about the collaborations you've got on the debut album, because some great names on there, Lizzie Hale, Michael Starr, Tyler Connolly, the list goes on. How did that all come to be? Did you approach them?
Yeah, I did. So basically, this album was inspired by Slash's first solo album, which was just his self-titled one that he did with a bunch of different artists. And I wanted to do something like that, but with the artists that I loved growing up. So I had kind of a list of like my dream people that I wanted. And that was, people I had as posters on my wall. Like, I had a Steel Panther poster on my wall when I was a kid. And like me, I have so many amazing memories of me and my mum singing like Hailstorm on the way to school and, nice things like that. So I had this list of like dream collaborators. And then I literally just messaged them on Instagram, like the power of social media, I guess. Just, with my pitch, I sent my YouTube channel and a lot of them were like actually like quite interested and yeah, sent them the songs and they were really into it. So yeah, it was incredible.
I mean, I was just watching the video for Imposter Syndrome, which is obviously you and Lizzie Hale. I mean, first and foremost, I mean, she's an incredible guitarist in her own right, but then the voice, the singer she is as well. Watching that video, do you still kind of pinch yourself? You're like, what? I'm doing that?
Literally. Yeah, it's so weird. Like yeah, because Lizzie's like someone that I've looked up to for years, just being like a female in like the rock industry as well. She's also just like the sweetest person. Like when I went to meet her after her show, she was just so like attentive to what I was saying. And it was cool because for that song, we had a really like deep conversation about, how we related to each other in terms of imposter syndrome and performance anxiety and being a woman in that sort of industry. And it was cool because she took lines that I said to her, like, the sentences I said during that conversation, and she put them into the song. And so it was cool how she really like listened and put that into the music, which made it really special. And yeah, it's still incredible. I got to perform with her and Joe at Heavy Music Awards as well, which was, at Wembley, which was one of my favorite moments ever.
Wow.
I'm just a fangirl at heart, really.
She's great though, Lizzie. I mean, there's a lot of great people in the world of rock music, but she's up there. She's definitely one of the good ones, isn't she?
100%, yeah,
Lovely.
definitely.
So who would you, I suppose, if you had sort of dream collaborators going down the line, would there be any sort of guitar heroes that you'd like to team up with or duet with, perhaps?
Oh yeah, there'd be loads. Like I'd love to
Yeah.
do something with Joe Satriani was like my very first kind of guitar influence. Like Surfing with the Alien was the first like instrumental album I got really, really into. I also love Steve Vai's collaborations, like he did one with Orianthe that I'd loved. I'd love to do something like that. Slash as well, like I said, his career kind of inspired what I want to do. So
Why
yeah,
wouldn't that
that
happen? Why wouldn't that happen?
I
Surely
don't
that's got to
know.
happen. You must know
It would be
people. I know
incredible.
people. We can talk to people. We can make that
Yes, let's do
happen.
it. Let's put it
Surely.
in the works.
It
But
seems so obvious.
also like Joe Bonamassa, like I love like the kind of bluesy stuff as well, and he's been a big influence too. So yeah, there's lots of people. So yeah, let's put the wheels in motion. Let's
Yeah, let's
go.
do it. Let's do it. We'll arrange that. But yeah, teaming up with MGK as well. I mean, the touring you've done with him, that must have been a kick.
Yeah, that was incredible because it was like I went from gigging to like at the local pub like Purple Turtle in Reading or something to like 200 people to suddenly the next weekend being on stage in front of 16,000 at an arena. And I think that jump, I was worried that I'd be really nervous, but actually that jump when I got out there and I stood on stage, I was really like, okay, this is where I'm meant to be, this is what I'm meant to be doing. And that was really like just an incredible moment because I guess you don't really know how you're going to react in that a situation because it's so, I don't know, it's so different to normal life. Like, I'm just a normal girl sit at home with my cats and stuff. So suddenly being on tour with a bunch of rocker dudes, it's, you know, it's definitely a different experience, but it's been incredible. The shows are absolutely amazing. Tour bus sucks, but you know,
oh, well,
that's the only
you'll live
negative
with that.
part.
What's the adrenaline dump like after that? You know, you play those shows of MGK, you're on stage, I mean, you're absolutely slaying it, and then you're off, you're like, oh.
Yeah, it's definitely funny. Like, you always have like tour blues as well, where you kind of feel a bit down after because it is such a high. It's like a drug, you know. And then it's you kind of have to level back to normal life. But you know, it's nice because like we have such an amazing crew. And there's always something going on, so it's nice we come back off stage. Often I'll have like you know my fiance doesn't come out to visit, and we'll just like carry on the party. It's really fun.
Amazing. Oh, congratulations as well. I
Oh,
gather
thank
you got
you.
engaged.
We did, yes. I'm so excited.
Amazing. So is there a big day planned as of yet? Do you know? Is that just in the pipeline?
There is. No, I've gotten like way too obsessed with it that I've actually already booked the venue for next year,
Amazing.
May 2025.
Fantastic. Well, hopefully the weather will be shining for you. I'm sure it will be.
It
So
probably won't be knowing me.
but what you've got store for this year though? I mean, surely plenty going on.
Yeah, we've got lots. So we know that we're doing some dates with MGK over the summer and stuff in America and some in Mexico, which will be fun. And then we also really want to get like going with our stuff, like playing our stuff live as well. We want to go on like an imposter syndrome album tour kind of thing. I'm not too sure what that will look like yet. We're still in like the early stages of kind of learning, making sure we've got all the songs down and stuff, and then we'll actually start building the show because like obviously it's a lot of collaborators and we don't sing.
Yeah.
So it's like, should we bring one vocalist to sing all of them? Do we get different ones? Like there's a lot of options, but I think that's what makes it kind of exciting. And then I'd also like to be writing some more music, probably releasing as singles, but with people that like you wouldn't really expect. Like I'd like to challenge myself to get into some different genres and stuff. Like I'd love to try some R&B gospel stuff. That's something
Okay.
I've never done before, but I'd like to give it a go just to see what I can take from that, you know, and maybe bring things I learned from that genre back into the rock world, I think would be fun.
Why not? I mean, you've got plenty of time. You're so young and you've done so much already. So, you know.
Oh, thank you. I don't feel it. I feel 50 years old.
Hey, look, don't joke. I'm 47 now. And it was 5 minutes ago, seriously, that I was your age,
Is
honestly. So.
crazy. It's crazy how quick time goes, especially like post-COVID. Everything, I don't know, it's so weird, man. It's creepy.
Yeah, it is. But hey, listen, good luck with the rest of this year. You're only just getting started, so
Thank you so much.
I can't wait to see what you've got lined up next.
Thank you so much.
I'm sure it's going to be a fantastic ride.
I'm
And
excited.
let's see if we can't get you teamed up with Slash.
Yes, let's go. I'm hoping this will happen. 2024 is the year of Sophie and Slash, and it goes so well.
Exactly,
Sophie and
exactly.
Slash.
Avengers assemble. Let's do it.
Yes.
Sophie, thank you.
Thank you so much. It was so nice to chat to you.